beautiful. It's it's very raw, it's very emotional. Distracted. Sometimes it's difficult for me to concentrate on a book for a long time. For some reason, comic books I can get through a lot more easily. Maybe it's something about the visualization. Maybe I have trouble with the visualization, and then I need the visuals to concentrate because it gives me something to focus on. Whereas if I'm just reading a book, I have to focus on what's in my head, and what's in my head is very complicated. It's hard for me to focus on one quiet task. It's hard for me. When I was a kid, I was an avid reader. I would read all the time so much. I had better focus back then, but I really, really want to finish this book. So far, it's incredibly intriguing. It's just, it's beautiful. But was actually thinking of doing a reading of this book, but in audible whispering, because honestly, this is not public domain. Like, I could probably read the Jungle Book, but not this one. It is very much copyrighted and very much recent. But if you are an avid reader, or if you want to get into something new, this is a good one. All started, right? Here is Emily Dickinson. And I'm going to get some sounds out of it. And then I'm going to read a little bit for you. Is that she never titled any of her poems, so the title of the poem is always the first line, or at least the first few words. I think it's the first line. So the title of this one is called A Clock Stopped, Not the Vandals, and that's the first line of the poem, so let's go ahead and read it. A Clock Stopped, Not the Vandals. Geneva's farthest gale can't put the puppet bowing that just now still, and all came on the trinket. The figures hunched with pain, then quivered out of decimals into degreeless noon. It will not stir for doctors, this pendulum of snow. This shopman importunes it, while cool, concernless snow nods from the gilded pointers, nods from the second slim decades of arrogance between the dial, life and him. Essentially, what poetry is. Poetry is metaphor and hidden meaning, if it's done right. Hers are very complex. I'm not really always sure what she's talking about. So let's read another one from this next page. Far from the Heavenly Father. Far from the Heavenly Father leads the chosen child. Oftener through realm of briar than the meadow mild. Oftener by the claw of dragon. Guides Actually, let's read the next one. On the wondrous sea. On the wondrous sea, sailing silently, knowest thou the shore? Ho, pilot, ho, where no breakers roar, where the storm is o'er. In the silent west, many sails at rest, their anchors fast. Thither I pilot thee, land ho, eternity ashore at last. The soul that has a guest does seldom go abroad. Diviner crowd at home obliterate the need, and courtesy forbid a host's departure, when upon himself be visiting the emperor of men. That one's interesting. I think what is true of her, she didn't travel much, correct me if I'm wrong. So she just kind of enjoyed what she had, and she stayed where she was, which is exactly what we are doing now. We are not traveling. Next one. Fame is a fickle food upon a shifting plate, whose table once a guest, but not the second time, is set, whose crumbs the crows inspect, and with ironic caw flap past it to the farmer's corn. Men eat of it and die. Oh, that's interesting. The dangers of fame, which is what she despised. She did not want to be famous. She wanted to be, as far as I know, because I don't know if any of you have Apple TV Plus, the series Dickinson, she seemed to want to publish her writing. Of course, it's a very, take it with a grain of salt kind of series, because it's very, very modernized. It's still set in her times, but it's different. It's very different. And I don't know if that's accurate, that she wanted so badly to be published, but her father wouldn't let her, or if it was that she just didn't want fame. But that poem kind of makes you think maybe she avoided fame. She was very much, I think, a recluse. I'm not sure if it's on her own will to be a recluse, or if she was kind of forced to be a recluse because of the times when women just weren't allowed to be worldly. They couldn't travel, they couldn't do much without a man, and that's just, it's a terrible time for a creative person, a woman who wants to be creative, a woman who wants to express herself. Definitely didn't belong back then. So let's read one more. Perception of an object costs precise the object's loss. Perception in itself again replying to its price. The object absolute is not perception, sets it fair, and then upbraids a perfectness that situates so far. Interesting. Beautiful. Okay, just one more, actually. One more, because I just saw this one and it looks nice. There is another loneliness that many die without. Not want or friend occasions it, or circumstance or lot, but nature sometimes thought, and whoso it befall, is richer than could be divulged by mortal numeral. I like that one. That one's gorgeous. She really loved nature, at least according to the series Dickinson. Because I recommend, if you have Apple TV Plus, or if you could borrow a code from a friend or something. I'm not trying to promote illegal activity, but you can share it, right? And it's a fun series. So I just want to say thank you for listening to me rant about several random things to do with books and Emily Dickinson. And I hope you enjoyed this video, got some tingles and relaxation. And I will see you next time.